So we've seen underbarrel launchers that can shoot lethals and tacticals, grenade launchers. We've seen underbarrel shotguns. And now we have an underbarrel chainsaw for the first time in Call of Duty history in the form of the JAK Limb Ripper. This is the newest aftermarket part that just released today. You're able to earn it by completing 5 challenges from week 2. And I want to talk about it. I want to give you guys some gameplay of it and just kind of go over what this thing is all about and how it works in game. When this thing originally leaked a few weeks back, I was really excited to get my hands on it. And now that it's finally here, it is most certainly a novelty weapon. You can be really successful with this thing if you have a team that is just not paying attention, a team that doesn't expect you to come up right behind them. Basically, in order to use this, just like you would imagine, you have to be point blank. You have to actually be touching the enemy just like you would be if you're using any other melee weapon in this game. And apart from using a standard combat knife or a karambit or anything like that, I just don't recommend it. I just don't recommend using it for that particular reason. In fact, you can get a kill with this thing just a little bit faster than if you were to just double melee. If we really wanted to go there, you're probably better off utilizing one of the multiple muzzles that allow you to do more melee damage, giving you a one-hit melee from the front. You're actually going to have a lot more fun in that regard because you still need to be within melee range in order to do any damage with this thing. But not only that, it's super finicky when it connects. You can have people laying prone on the ground, and one of the only ways to get them quickly is by either sliding into it or crouching into them. You can go prone and use this thing, so drop shotting is possible. I've been able to do it. It's not recommended all the time though, because you actively need to be against the enemy for it to actually work. Couple of downsides to the chainsaw. Number one, it does take about a second or a little bit under a second to get it revved up and actually doing damage. The second downside is you can't sprint while this is out. I think that that would have been the biggest selling point of this chainsaw. If you could actually sprint while revving this, it would have immediately been a better weapon, because 9 times out of 10, when you're chasing down an enemy, you have to fight against revving it up to do the damage, and then of course keeping pace with the enemy in order to actually connect with them to do the damage. So if that sprint capability was there, this would be so much better. So I tried switching up my gear and the perks to see maybe if I could put on reload while sprinting, maybe that would allow me to hold the trigger and sprint, but unfortunately that is not the case. And maybe I'm missing something. If I'm completely wrong about that, let me know down below in the comments section. I will say this though, I really, really wish that there was some sort of special ability with this, allowing you to do a charge, kind of like in previous World War II games like Vanguard, where we had bayonets and we could charge forward, giving us a little burst of speed to make it closer to the enemy and close the gap. I think that's what this is really missing. And if they were to add something like that, I don't think it would make it unbalanced by any means, because you still are required to hit the enemy multiple times with it before it actually takes them down. So if you come across someone using a shotgun, a sniper, or even another melee weapon, and they happen to get lucky with a hip fire, you're done before the chainsaw can do its job, which is unfortunate, but I guess I kind of get it. I really like using this in Horde Point specifically to take down the zombies, and then that got me thinking, what about actual zombies? So I jumped over to MWZ, and to say I was surprised is an understatement. This thing works really well in the tier 1 zone, even without a pack-a-punch and even without a weapon upgrade. If you wanted to take it that extra step, pack-a-punching it to level 3 and then upgrading your weapon to orange rarity, it does do quite a bit of damage, and it can be extremely useful in the tier 1 and tier 2 zone. Tier 3 though, not so much. You're gonna get swarmed pretty quickly because the zombies move a lot faster, and it doesn't seem to do that much damage. Unfortunately, this also isn't that good to use against disciples since they are so high up, but I found that if you jump up and down while actually revving the chainsaw, you can get headshots a little bit easier, which means taking down disciples can happen, at least in the tier 2 zone. Don't try it in the tier 3 zone, it's just not recommended at all. It also didn't seem to work too well when it came to the HVTs that you encounter through contracts, and it's mainly because they have a little more health than standard HVTs, and it's still plausible, it's still a possible thing that you're able to do, it's just not as efficient as just using the bullets from your gun to take the enemy down faster, and of course from a safer distance. Once again, you still gotta be point blank to take these enemies down. Since I knew it was going to be point blank, I decided to combine it with the cryo freeze weapon mod, and that seemed to work pretty well, and I did enjoy my time while playing with this in zombies. I think with a few tweaks and updates, this could definitely be a fun weapon to utilize. And also, I should mention, there's a little bit of a bug going on with this. I don't know if it's going to be fixed by the time this video comes out, but if you're playing free-for-all and you try to use this, you will damage yourself. So do not use this, at least in free-for-all. Sledgehammer said that there is a fix on the way. They are aware of it. I just figured I would show you that if you're in free-for-all, this is what ends up happening if your chainsaw ends up colliding with a wall, or if you touch anything that isn't an enemy, it's going to end up hurting you. So there you go. I want to talk a little bit about the Cryptid Bootcamp event that started today. There are 8 different challenges, and this includes a weapon blueprint at the end, as well as a camouflage pattern that you can earn for completing an in-game challenge. This is what that camo pattern looks like, by the way. And what you're required to use is the covert sneakers and the blacklight flashlight at the same time, both of which are perks, and they can be equipped pretty easily. You got to get 75 kills with both of those equipped, and you can use any weapon you want. There are a couple of challenges that do require you to switch up your perks, one of which requires you to use a marksman rifle with an aftermarket part while also using the stalker boots as well as the threat identification system perk. So don't be a dum-dum like me and use just the conversion kit and then not let it scroll and read the rest of what you need to do, because you could go 4 or 5 games using the same weapon and not actually unlock anything like I did. Anyway, when there's a lot of stuff that you need, I wish there was actually a way to like click on the actual challenge to show it instead of having to wait for the whole thing to scroll through over and over and over again. The good news is, if you didn't feel like playing multiplayer, you can jump into zombies in order to complete these challenges, and they range from just getting throwing knife kills to using specific weapons or doing specific things in game. Like, for example, if you wanted to unlock the looking at you camo pattern, you actually have to kill 3 abominations. It's not too difficult, but that's going to require you to go to the tier 3 zone in order to fight those things. So I'm definitely happy that the option's there for those that want to go that route. And I think that there are some challenges that may be more suited for zombies. Like, for example, we did get an update to our Horde Hunt event today, which did add the Dogs of Hell calling card. This requires you to collect Hellhound skulls. So, of course, you can go into zombies and pick up the skulls that way. Alternatively, you can play Horde Point. They did update it in order to add Hellhounds, and this does add an interesting mix to the entire situation. And I'm guessing when they finally unlock the cursed ammo, they'll most likely update Horde Point again to add mimics, which we actually did see a few promotional screenshots of Horde Point showing the mimic, but it doesn't exist yet, so I don't know. That's probably what's going to end up happening. But anyway, that is it. That's all I wanted to talk about here in this video today. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below about the new underbarrel chainsaw. Is it something that you enjoy? Did you go on a nice little streak? When you do, it feels good, but otherwise, you're just kind of like left in the dust. Anyway, thanks for watching. Appreciate you guys coming out. Drop a like, subscribe for more. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.